ಸಂಪನ್ನ ಪಾರಿಜಾತಾಯ ತೋತ್ರ ವೇತ್ರೈಕ ಪಾಣಯೇ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಮುದ್ರಾಯ ಕೃಷ್ಣಾಯ ಗೀತಾಮೃತ ದುಹೇ ನಮಃ. ಹರಿ ಓಂ. ಮೈ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ಸಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೇಯರ್ಸ್ ಮೇ ಆಲ್ ಮೈಟಿ ಗಿವ್ all kinds of prosperity, good health, wealth and eternal happiness to the entire viewers of Sri Venkateswara Bhakthi Channel. Namaskar. Srimad Bhagavadgeeta, first chapter, verse number 20. Atha vyavasthitan drashtva dhartarashtran kapidhvajaha pravritte sastra sampate ಧನುರುದ್ಯಮ್ಯ ಪಾಂಡವ. ವರ್ಷ ನಂಬರ್ 21. ಹೃಷಯಕೇಶಂ ತದಾ ವಾಕ್ಯಂ ಇದಮಾಹ ಮಹೀಪತೆ ಅರ್ಜುನ ಉವಾಚ ಸೇನಯೋರುಭಯೋರ್ಮಧ್ಯೆ ರಥಂ ಸ್ಥಾಪಯ ಮೇಚ್ಯುತ. ಅಥ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥಿತಾನ್ ಧಾರ್ತರಾಷ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ದೃಷ್ಟ್ವಾ ಕಪಿಧ್ವಜಃ. ಅಥ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್, or immediately after the all noise and sounds of that drums, trumpet, everything had happened, this Arjuna might have thought in his mind, the moment for which he was waiting for 13 years, because his cousins Duryodhana etc. had done injustice to the Pandavas. He wanted to give it back, to establish dharma. There is no revenge or avenge, to establish dharma. Though the story, it seems to be these Pandavas are showing revenge, means taking revenge. No, there is no revenge or avenge. They wanted to, especially this dharma, Yudhishthira, he wanted to quit the battle. That's what, you know, this, the moment which had come in order to give it back everything, now he prepared the body language. So because he was a great warrior, you know, warriors, they prepare themselves by seeing enemies. When they see enemies, their eyes will become red, and their all nerves will become hot, and you know, it will become like a iron. Then their mind, you know, it will be loaded, boosted with lots of tons of energy, like a current shock, like they har har mahadev, that's what, you know, they shout something else, like, you know, this Arjuna, he just the body language, it showed that he prepared dhanurudyamya, having his bow, Pandavaha means Arjuna, before all the missiles have been, or before all the missiles to be shot. Hrishikesham va idam vakyamah. He said something to Lord Krishna. Hey Mahipate. Mahipate means Sanjaya's narrating to Dhritarashtra. Arjuna uvacha. Arjuna said, Senayor ubhayor madhye ratham sthapaya me achyuta. Achyuta means that which never are imperishable. That which is imperishable. This achyuta, Senayor ubhayor madhye me ratham sthapaya. Please place or establish my chariot between both armies. Oh, this is something different, because you know, he wanted to see those enemies. They were in the long distance, therefore what, he wanted to look at them, to see them from near. That's what intention Arjuna had. Now in this place, I have to make you to realize one more thing. This Krishna, he accepted to be a charioteer to Arjuna. Okay, that we know already. But you know the duty of the charioteer? When charioteer is driving, at that time, in those days, there were no this, walkie-talkies or some kind of godless or like this kind of mic. No. No provisions of audio system. And that too, that battlefield not like, you know, being in our place and shooting rocket from here. No. They have to be amidst the battle. They should be among this all bloody, fleshy, that noisy environment. And it will be like a chaos. At that time, during that time, if they want to drive the chariot, it's a challenging job. And the king who is, fighting, they cannot communicate, they cannot shout, because when they shout, these people cannot hear anything. And that too, how many times they could shout, because the shouting, if they lose, they may lose energy. Therefore, what they used to do, if the chariot to be taken towards right, they press on the right shoulder of a charioteer with the toes. Now you see, Arjuna did it. Arjuna and Krishna also accepted it. That is the glory of Krishna. Ananyaschintayanto mam ye jena pariyupasate tesham nityabhiyuktanam yoga kshemam vahamyaham. Those the devotees who think always about me, I am there to help them. Even materialistic helps. Yoga kshemam aham vahami. I will give materialistic help, whatever the way is possible. And I also manifest myself when there is a decay of dharma and the growth of adharma. Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyutthanam adharmasya tadatmanam srijamyaham. I manifest myself as a charioteer even, why not? That's what Krishna is. And you should not forget, after Mahabharata war completed, Gandhari gave a shap, a curse to Krishna to destroy all that his vamshas, too much lost. That's what Krishna is. He knew already. He looked at Arjuna. He didn't say anything. Just he took the chariot. But the reason Arjuna also said to Krishna, let me read it. Yavad etanire kreham yodhakamana vasthitana kairmaya sahayodhavyam asmin rana samudyame. Asmin ramana samudyame. In this battle, kaihi maya sahayodhavyam. To be fought with whom? By me. Yodhakaman avasthitan than aham nirikshe. The people who are desirous of battle, I want to see them. I want to see them face to face. That's my intention, to boost my energy. He said it like that. Then the next words. Yotsyamanana vekshaham yaye tetra samagataha dhartarashtrasya durbuddhehe yuddhe priyachikirshavaha. Durbuddhehe dhartarashtrasya priyachikirshavaha yaye te. అత్ర సమాగతాః యోత్స్యమానాన్ సమాగతాః అహం అవేక్షే. I would like to see the people, those who are wishing to help this evil-minded Duryodhana in the battle. That is the meaning. Durbuddhehe dushta buddhihi yasya saha. The person, one who is endowed with evil mind. And priya chikirshavaha. It's a beautiful verb, you know. Priyam chikirshavaha. So who wants to help, to do welfare, good thing to Duryodhana? I want to see all the people, because they are the supporter of adharma. See, to support adharma, you need not to have that clarity of dharma and adharma to support adharma. Are you understanding what I say? Because of the lack of clarity of dharma and adharma, people may support adharma, but knowingly, I am supporting for adharma, but I will die definitely, still I have to fight. This is the condition of Bhishmacharya. Therefore, Arjuna wants to see the enemies, but not knowing what is going to take place. He was so confident. And this Bhishma kind of people, if you see them, somebody who is enemy, but not because of their vengeance, because of the situation, then you won't get that much enmity, first of all. Because something went unfortunately happened. Accidentally, you know, some people accidentally they become actor. Accidentally they become something businessman. So accidentally something happens, you know, accidentally. So this attitude to see them, I want to see them completely. Then Krishna, Krishna, I think he takes the chariot, but Krishna is not speaking here. He will begin in the second chapter. Sanjaya uvacham eva mukto hrishikeshaha gudakeshena bharata senayor ubhayor madhye sthapayitva rathottamam. Sanjaya said to Dhritarashtra, evam uktaha hrishikeshaha, thus said Lord Krishna by Gudakesha. Gudakesha means what? Gudakesha means, Gudaka means nidra, sleep. Who had conquered nidra, sleep, that person can be called Gudakesha. Gudakayaha Ishena. Gudaka, Gudakayaha Ishena. It has become Gudakeshena. The person, one who has got victory over sleep. And Gudaka means, one more meaning, sloth, drowsiness. He was so powerful warrior, so we cannot think ever with him, even our Napoleon Bonaparte. This Napoleon Bonaparte had a quality, a power. Whenever he wants to sleep, he can sleep. It is said that he used to sleep even in the battlefield, on the horse. When a horse, you know, say riding horse is not an easy thing. It's not an easy chair. Because you need to have a strong back and muscles trained body. So he used to sleep in the battlefield. See, getting victory over sleep means not always awaken as Lakshmana did for 14 years. He didn't sleep at all. Because he wanted to do seva to his brother, therefore he didn't sleep at all for 14 years. After coming back to Ayodhya, then Nidra Devi was occupying him. It's not like that. Getting victory over sleep means whenever they want to have a sleep, they could have sleep. That's what Arjuna. And Guda means one more meaning, you know. Gudavat Kesha. Gudavat Kesha Yasya Saha. Bahuri. Gudavat means, Guda means there is one meaning, you know. This thumb and this both finger. So keeping this is called mudra. This is called chin mudra. But somehow thumb and there is a word here. It's given. So guda means mudra visheshaha. That mudra is like that. Guda means this is a curling hair. That curling hair. The person one who is with curling hair called guda kesha. That guda keshaha. By listening to his word, he took the chariot between two armies. See, when he took the chariot, he took right exactly in front of Bhishma and Drona. This Krishna also sometimes, you know, very clever. Let him to be burst. Then we will give the, because you know, once battle is began, nothing can be done. So if at all anything to be done, it has to be before the battle, okay? Therefore, he made it directly in front of Acharya and great grandfather. That's what. Bhishma Drona Pramukhataha. The next words. Bhishma Drona Pramukhataha. Sarvesham Chamahikshitam. Uvachapartha Pashyaitan. Samavetan Kuruniti. Though Krishna speaks, but Vyasacharya, he is not bringing as Krishna Uvacha. Just he said Sanjaya Uvacha. He took the chariot right in front of this Bhishma and Drona and he placed it and said, look at these people. Okay. So look at all these people, all these kings. Pasya etan samavetan kuru niti. Look at this, all kurus. That's what the main event for Arjuna to get a different Arjuna. Till now, so Arjuna is a normal warrior Arjuna. And when he is about to see those people, Krishna is very alert. Because any karmapala will take place, it comes through us alone. You know, this is like, you know, one person, he said, today morning, you know, I should have started from my home right exactly by 8:20. So, but I started by 8:25, you know, therefore, I met with an accident. That is, you know, human mind thinks in that way. So, if I would have began a little bit early, I would have not met with an accident. Yeah, it seems to be quite logical. But that is the fact, you cannot be started before 8:25. And you become the valuable tool for your own karma phala, your thoughts, your activities, your words and your gestures. So all these things are the valuable tool in order to get the karma phala from outside. This Arjuna alone told to take the chariot in between, to place the chariot in between the both armies. Now he is about to, now karma phala is, everything is together. Now the next word, tatra pashyan sthitan parthaha pitronatha pitamahan acharyan matulan bhratrun putran pautran sakhim statha. Partha tatra apashyat, tatra sthitan apashyat. Just, you know, he was about his energy. He looked at opposite. he looked like that, then his eyes became small. Because he was expecting the enemies, but there were no enemies were found. Pitronatha Pitamahan Acharyan Matruan Bratrun. All these great grandfathers, Acharyas means teachers, masters, Matulan means all the uncles, maternal, paternal uncles, all these sibilants, all sons, Sakhim, even friends, so he could see. You know that situation. So suddenly, you know, mind has got a habitual tendency. Suddenly he felt, where I am. Because when you go to a marriage or some function, you meet all the relatives with what? With a battle mood? No. You meet with them smiling face, welcoming face. That is the trained mind. Now when he wanted to boost his energy, he was not able to boost the energy. That's what happened with Arjuna. When he looked at Acharyan, Matulan, Bhratrun, Putran, Pautran, Sakhim, Statha, not only that, he also could see many more people, relatives. Shvashodhan, Sohrdash, Chaiva, Senayoru, Bhayorapi. Even, you know, these well-wishers from both sides, not from one side. He looked here and there, from outside. Then he said, this is not a marriage ceremony, this is not a function, or this is not some puja event, this is a battlefield. What is going on? Because, you know, your mind is victimized unknowingly within a fractions of second. Then buddhi should come into the scene to judge or realize what had happened before that. But he was just, mind, when you see physically, it gets affected very soon. Though these people were waiting for battle, at least, minimum 13 years. Now suddenly, the next verse describes how Arjuna went. Tansam ikshasakaunteyaha sarvan bandhuna vasthitana kripaya paraya vishtaha vishidannidam abravita. Tan sarvan bandhun, tan avasthitan sarvan bandhun samikshya. So all the relatives who were there, by seeing them, he was overwhelmed by what? Kripaya paraya vishtaha. He was not able to judge what the feeling or what the emotions are taking place. He might have felt somebody, kept 1,000 tons of rock on his head or on his chest. Something, it is nagging him. That's what he felt. With all sad mood, he speaks to Krishna. Arjuna uvacha drashtve mam sojanam Krishna yuyotsum samavasthitam sidanti mama gatrani mukham cha parishushyati. Now his buddhi is realizing what is going on. The logic, this is not the marriage, this is not the puja, this is not some function. So this is not even some kind of army day, we just go for a parade. Now, then he says, drishta imam sojanam drishtva. By seeing my own people, yuyutsum samavasthitam. The people who have been rearranged or organized for the battle, they are my own people by seeing all these people. Mama gatrani sidanti. I am not able to stand. And he keeps, and my mouth becomes dry. I am not able to stand. Now he could see physically, you know, the reaction comes. Then from here, he begins his opinion about the battle. And his opinion about dharma. His opinion about all the human being with a confused mind. What is it? Why it is confused? Because they were ready to fight. If he stops, they are not going to stop. Because they were with all determination. That is the situation. We will continue from next episode. Thank you. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantih. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.